welcome to the session. My name is Marco Dinoy. I'm the head of e-commerce sales for Germany and emerging markets at Chao. And yeah, for me, the first time here in Sofia, would like to say a big thank you to Plamen, who organized this event really, really well and compared to other countries. Yeah, and today I would like to show you how the retail can really make use of user-generated content. Okay, sorry. And you will see that user-generated content showed us in the last 5 years, I'm working since 5 years for Chao, that users are the best sellers. And all across Europe, also big retailers see the same like we see at Chao. And I will show you why. First of all, a short agenda, what I would like to tell you regarding online shopping are some trends, potential in several countries. Then we will talk about trust. Today, if you would like to be successful, the user have to have trust in you and your product. The next point will be then user-generated content in action. What to do and what maybe not to do. I will show you some really nice screenshots regarding this. And last but not least, some information about Chao. I'm sure that not everybody knows Chao. Who knows Chao? Hey, cool. Seven. Not bad. Let's start with online shopping. You can see here a trend across Europe. So it means how many online shoppers are really doing online shopping in these countries. And you see that in every country, there's a huge potential. Means if you, as a retailer, have an idea to expand your business, do it. We are on the World Wide Web, and expanding is absolutely necessary, and do it. You would see Spain and Italy, for example, are really big countries in compared to Netherlands and Sweden. But Spain and Italy, regarding online shopping, are below Netherlands and Sweden. The good thing is that Italy and Spain are really growing fast, and I will show you why. First of all, there must be a clarification regarding, okay, what is social commerce? On the right side, you see the user-driven side, means you have social communities like Facebook, MySpace, YouTube, etc. Then you have business networks like LinkedIn or also Xing in Germany, for example. On the left side, you see provider-driven sites like producers and online shops. And the main focus for everybody who would like to be successful in retail should focus on the middle, means editorial tests, forums, blogs, and consumer portals, like Chao is, are absolutely important today if you would like to run your business in a successful way. Here, a screenshot regarding Comscore in Germany. So we have the top 20 retailer regarding traffic. And you will see that 7 of these sites are price comparison sites, like Chao. Chao is the biggest one because we have a community. Means we have a lot of content, relevant content, for users. And this shows that these comparison sites have the right focus. And this shows also that 12 of the top 20 in Germany, 12 of the top 20 retailer, introducing right now user reviews. Because they saw, hey, user reviews today are absolutely important because this means automatically trust. If you have trust, this means automatically, if you have user-generated content, you have a key factor, and this is relevant content. Here we have two screenshots, one Google, one Bing. Bing is a new search engine by Microsoft, cool site, by the way. And you will see Privileg Waschmaschinen. Someone knows what is Privileg, the brand, ever heard? Yeah, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's a brand by a huge company called Quelle. It's a part of Akandor. Right now they have some issues, can happen. But you see here that unfortunately, they realized too late how important relevant content or user-generated content is for them. And you will see that they will spend every time money on AdWords, because you see also that the search results are every time price comparison site or opinion portals. Means relevant content for a user that is trying to find something. And this is absolutely important today. You need relevant content. In a short one, communication and online shopping are the most important web activities today. So it means if you go into the internet, I think some years ago, it was really cool to chat with some, let's say girls or men, depends on you. This changed. Today, the people really are looking forward to see, okay, I want to express myself. I want to talk about my own opinion. I want to get in contact with other people. And this is communication. And online shopping, absolutely important. If today you would like to buy something, first of all, you have to do research. And where do you do the research? In the internet. And this is the way or the trend for the future. Here, a short screenshot regarding Germany. That's a market for what I'm working for. And you see that in 2008, Germany made only with the e-commerce business about 28 billion euros. That's amazing. 2009, hopefully, we will get about 31 billion euros, also nice. And by 2014, there will be an increase of 40%. And Germany is becoming more and more famous regarding the e-commerce. And this is a trend that is across Europe. It's absolutely important to see what kind of potential you as retailer will have in future if you use the e-commerce part, social commerce. Absolutely important. Now let's come to a point that for me and also for you is absolutely important. Because today, if a user don't have trust in your product, on your site, he will never buy something. Because he's asking, okay, why should I buy something there and not somewhere else? And here you have some big companies, researchers that says that this trust is a especially hot topic. And it is. You can see consumers trust peer reviews more than anything else. That's amazing. That's a trend. And this shows how the business has to go in future. Online shopping offers a lot of benefits for consumer. Means you're independent. You can see, for example, if you decide, okay, I want to buy this camera or this TV, you can directly see, okay, which product is available and which not. Then you have several products where you can choose. Would I like to have a Sony, Panasonic, etc. Then directly you can see how many shops can offer me this TV for a good price and also for a good service. Absolutely important. And the good thing is you can do this the whole time, around the clock. And that's cool. You can buy on Sunday, as soon as you had your breakfast. That's cool. It's comfort, And the good thing is regarding green company is really you don't have any petrol costs or parking fees. So you save money. Also nice. Now let's see the difference between offline and online sales. Thing is every time, you have a wish, you would like to buy something. What do I really need? And the thing is that in the internet, you have various sources where you can see, okay, this is maybe important, this is maybe cool, this is maybe what I would like or wanted to have since years. And this is the advantage of the internet. Product demonstration, touch, is something like, the offline sales has an advantage right now, but the e-commerce or the internet is becoming more and more successful. They have pictures, videos, product videos, rich media. They show you, hey, this product is really cool, several features, etc. And this is absolutely interesting and also a trend for the future. Identify buy assignments. This means if a user is coming to your site, you have promotional articles. You have user lists that users had said, okay, this product is really cool. It's really good. And this is an advantage for you as retailer in the e-commerce part. Display dubs is something like if someone is coming to your site and you know several users before that the user come every time to the site is never buying something, do something like cross-selling, offer something additional. And this is really easy in the internet on your website to implement this. Really cool stuff. Decision support. Sorry, I was out yesterday and drank too much. Yeah, true. Decision support. The thing is, if you go and would like to buy something, normally, if I buy a camcorder, every time my wife is coming with me, means, hey, I would like to spend this money, and she's telling me, maybe it's expensive, maybe watch for another camera or something like this. And the good thing is that in the internet, you're prepared. Means you're reading reviews regarding different cameras, where you can say, hey, this product is really good. Yeah? your testimonials, and your views opinions. So the argumentation in the offline sales is really perfect for you and your wife if you say, hey, this camcorder is really cool and would like to spend this 500 euros or more. And this is something that the internet is becoming more and more interesting for everybody. Here we have some conflicts, means spoiled for choice, financial sacrifice, right timing. And the internet will give you solutions. Means visibility on portals. This, by the way, is the chow site. Homepage will change. Social community will directly tell you, hey, go to this shop, you will have discount, etc., blah, blah. This works. And word of mouth, what is really good? And when should you do this? And this means information plus reliability means conversion. So if you build a trust between you and the user, you will have a high conversion, means more upsell. And this is the future. Here, a small research regarding how consumers get informed. And you see that 46% are reading testimonials about products and services. Read consumer reviews, really important. You can do this on sites. Look for family and friends' advice, but also they are looking to the internet, doing the research, what is good, what is bad. Some guys don't know. Trust on seller recommendations depends if you go to a media market and the guy is telling you, hey, this TV is the best TV because we as media market earn a lot of money on this, then should I trust or not? And yeah, some guys, they are trusting their own intuition. And this is something like you see where the trend is going. Means more information you have for the user, more successful you will be. Here, a really nice screenshot shows, for example, that 37% of German internet users change brand or product during the buying process. This is something like cross-selling. They inform, see maybe some other products that are also interesting, maybe cheaper, maybe better. And this is really interesting. Means 82%, it's a research that we did on our site in Germany, have already changed new consumer reports the purchase decision. And this is something like, it's amazing. Really, because if you have an idea to buy a Panasonic TV, for example, and you say, hey, I really like this design, it's really cool, but you see a lot of reviews on several sites, also, for example, on Chao, that are telling you, hey, this Panasonic TV is looking really fine, but the features are not so good, like, for example, Philips. And this is something like where you change your decision. And this is absolutely important for you if you implement on your site, as a retailer, several opportunities for the user to say, not only this product is interesting, also other products are interesting. And this can make the difference. I talked some slides ago regarding Spain and Italy, that they are behind Netherlands and Sweden, really small countries, really cool countries. But here you see that Spain and Italy are growing really fast. And why they're growing fast? Because they see personal reviews are really helpful. And this means also a trend. They're growing, growing, and growing. And this regarding the information. If you have information, you automatically have trust. If you have both, you have conversion. And this is a really interesting point. Here also a research that we saw on several sites. Other users, reviews and comments, 52%. See a high credibility for online shoppers. Product reviews about internet pages on newspapers, magazines, also interesting. And product information about products on the internet is okay, but will not help you in your decision. Here we have a nice example. 2 weeks ago, one of my friends told me, hey, my bike was stolen. And I said, can happen. Maybe still also one, something like this. But I told him, okay, let's do something like a cycle of an online purchase. How does it work today? First of all, you need the requirements. Means you do have to do a research. What kind of bike do you like? Are you living in the Alps? Are you living in the city? Are you driving every day 100 kilometers or maybe only two? Then you know, okay, what kind of bike should I take? Then product selection. If you decided to buy a mountain bike, you have several customers that are offering several bikes. So also there you need advice and opinions. Which bike is really good? Or where are the advantages? For me, for example, if I drive a bike, I do this, I think, once a week for 500 meters. For me, a bike is a bike. Must have a nice design. Must be a cool bike, something like this. Yeah. But other people that are really interested in this bike are looking for the features. What can this bike, for example, do? Is it good from the quality? Etc. Blah, blah, blah. There's so many factors regarding a purchase. Then the next advice and opinion is regarding the merchant selection. Means, okay, now I know what kind of brand I would like to have, and now I need to see which shop is the best shop to deliver me this bike. And here you need really this advice and opinions, because several shops are really good, but some shops are better than the other one. And here you have to see, okay, how is the experience that other user made, for example? The bike arrived not in 2 weeks, but maybe in 6 months, or something like, for me, not an issue, for other people, a real big issue. And so, therefore, this advice and opinion are absolutely important for the purchase experience. Later on, to finish the cycle, you have your personal experience that automatically is also necessary for other user. Because if you say, hey, I found this bike in the shop, I made this experience, and show this experience to other people, they will tell you really thank you for this. And this is something like everybody should or have to understand. That experience by other users means trust, and trust means conversion. Yeah, trust is, I think, the best or most important factor in purchase decision. Means users trust users. If, for example, a company like Sony writes an article about this new digital camera and telling you, yeah, that's the best camera, blah, 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 all the information that you need, do you trust these guys? No. Because normally you want to have an opinion regarding another human being like me. What is he thinking about this digital camera? And this is absolutely important, because some people see a digital camera really like, oh, nice color, it's a cool camera. And some people say, hey, this camera can do this, this, and this, a lot of features. And this is something like that will help me if I would like to do this purchase. Product reviews, what I'm talking about. Dealer reviews, hey, what kind of service do they have? Shop, brand. Your brand must become more and more famous, and you can do this if you involve the user into your product. Means trust. Visibility, yeah, the shop must be fine and nice, otherwise you will have no chance. Usability means it must be easy for a user. Because you have to think, a standard user is going to the internet, trying to find something, and then you have to click 10 times until you arrive to the product. This is not good. Therefore, you need a really good usability. A professional site and the seal. Yeah, user-generated content and action. This is a really important point, because several people saw user-generated content is absolutely important for me, like company, like retailer, but they do something wrong, and I will show you, please don't do this in the wrong way. Here we have online experts that are still uncertain about dealing with user-generated content. Means brands and dealers are changing their mind regarding portals that are offering reviews. They find this positive, and this is a trend. If big brands are telling or seeing, hey, reviews are becoming more and more important, then there must be something that is really interesting also for you as a retailer, because you would like to sell something, and this is the future. Another point, in the last 4 or 5 years, every time came big companies and told me, hey, what about negative reviews? For example, we had an issue to deliver something, and the user's writing, yeah, this company is really bad, they delivered this instead of 2 days and 2 weeks, and therefore I don't like this company. Blah, blah, blah. A lot of shops told me, hey, please delete this. And I told them, we cannot delete this, because this is an opinion that a user made. And the thing is, this is automatically for you and information how to do your business in a better way. This is absolutely positive if users are writing something about you. And you see that 38% directly give an answer on this. Yeah? This is the future. Means you have to interact with the user, otherwise you have no chance. Means use the user, use the trust, and then it works. Yeah, here we see a screenshot that is an ugly one, if I can say this. Here on the right side, you see, schreiben Sie die erste Bewertung. You know what it means? No. Okay. Write the first opinion. Review. Would you ever do this on this site? Do you have trust on this side if you see something like this? Your real opinion? Yes? No? Yes? Okay. No. Being there is not everything. Means only if you implement something like, please write a review. And your site, for example, is looking really like not nice. The user will never do this. Yeah. Here we have another screenshot. Something like, oh, wow, some pictures, no information. And you see, user Meinung, user reviews, 0, 0, 0. Means nobody will go to this site and write reviews regarding the product. It's an issue. You have to see this. And this is absolutely important for you if you would like to start or run a new business. Use the user-generated content in a good way. This is absolutely important. Don't make something like, hey, I implement this button, maybe it works, maybe, but it doesn't work. Do it in a good way. Here also the same. Yeah, thanks, really informative. Yeah, we'll buy this bike, thank you. No way, because you don't have any information regarding this review, for example. Here also, einfach super, alles drin, wo man braucht. Something like, yeah, thanks. My mother said, it's cool. Okay, now I will buy it. It's not helpful. Okay, here we have delay. Here also, the same. It's not useful. It's not looking fine. And this is experience, what I'm talking about. So we are every time in contact with our big retailers and all over Europe. They are spending tons of millions to have a better usability on their site. And if you remember the screenshot regarding the top 20 customers in Germany, they are implementing user reviews in a good way. They're doing this really fine. Because otherwise, the user will never come to your site and write a review. Means no content, no trust. Automatically, no conversion. Here, we start to have good quality reviews that will convince. It's better than the other sites, for sure. Here also, you see the product name. You see the price, and then you see, okay, there are 16, 18 reviews regarding this, and then the review start, yeah, regarding this product, one of these. This is something like interesting for user. You will not directly leave the site. You will stay there. You have attention, and this is important. Here, also, nice screenshot. Well done by the design. Something like works. And here, the best example, for sure. It's one of the over 5 million reviews Ciao offers across Europe. Means you see, there's a real long story, but absolutely important for other users. Because if today you would like to spend money, you would like to spend money in the right way. And therefore, you need the feedback by other customers, by other users. Otherwise, maybe you're buying or spending 200, 500 euro, and you're not happy with your product. Therefore, these quality reviews stand for trust and conversion. And show off your reputation. Up in den Urlaub is one big travel agency in Germany that used Ciao on the right side as powerful tool. Means if a user in Germany, everybody knows Ciao. That's a good point. In Bulgaria, not now. Maybe in some months, years, we don't know right now. But they use this button really like to increase their sales. Because if they see, hey, a lot of users wrote reviews regarding this service. I will trust them because, first of all, I would like to read these reviews. If you click on this button, you directly come to Ciao to the reviews. And everybody can implement this on his site for less. And this is something like use consumer portals because then you will generate content. Content means trust, means conversion. Here, oh, also a nice screenshot. You're going somewhere, buying something, I do. And then on the bill you can see, okay, hey, write a review regarding our service. Then you will get a discount. This is something like, it's really cool. It's an interaction between offline sales and online sales. This works. Here we have one of, yeah, let's say, smaller countries, but becoming more and more bigger, smaller shops, sorry, becoming more and more interesting and important for the German guys. It's Druckerzubehör. Means, yeah, printer stuff. Something like this. It's not a nice URL, by the way. Here, for example, if the user buys something in this shop, he will get an email by the shop, where the shop is telling them, hey, as soon as the product arrives at home, go to these sites, you see, Ciao in the first link, then Yopi also, Opinion Portal, Douyu also, really small compared to Ciao. And if you write, send a review, and you will send us this review, something like, hey, I wrote a review regarding your service, then you will get on this what you paid for the product, a discount of 10%. This is something that worked really, really fine for this company. He's the best hardware shop regarding reviews. And you will see why. With this action about 10% discount as soon as the products arrived at home, he generated within really a few months over 7,000 reviews. And this means trust. And this works. Do this. Give them the chance to say how your service is and give them also a discount. If you want to do business, you have to invest. And 10% discount is something like, hey, everybody can afford, I think. Really nice case study that we have. This is a really huge campaign that we started with HP. It's really amazing what kind of campaign we did in Germany. Something like there was a new product launched by HP, but it was not able to buy in the shop. Means you have to wait until it was really launched. And we talked with them and said, hey, let's do a pre-testing campaign. Let's say we will send your product to several users that can test this product for 1 week and tell you then how this product was. Was it good? Was it bad? What was good? What was bad? This worked in an amazing way. It was a huge campaign. The users are satisfied. HP is satisfied. And now we're thinking about doing this all over Europe. Because this is an interaction between a huge company like HP and a consumer portal like Ciao. And this is something like absolutely fascinating. This is really cool. Yeah, 4 good reasons why your customers should write reviews. It has never been so easy for customers to write reviews. Do this in the right way. Don't implement one button that maybe is not nice. Users today have access to different media. And this is important. They can do several things. This means automatically search engines, communities, and blogs have become respected by search engines, for example, also, and are right now credible sources. Means, as remember some slides before, Privileg Waschmaschinen, means if you have content on your site regarding this Privileg Waschmaschine, the search engine will show you as a price comparison site, or also you as a shop, if you have relevant content for search engines. And these consumer portals are becoming more and more famous in every country. And this is the first step for you as a retailer, if you start your business, go to the right sites and do the right things. Yeah, and reviews of products from users are considered and valued. And this is, yeah, the trend. Think about it and use it. Use user-generated content in the right way. First of all, use multipliers. Yeah? Identify relevant sites. On the right side, Ciao. Bit advertising. Check regularly your reviews. Means, what are people writing about you? You can go to the site and say, hey, every time a user is writing a review regarding my shop, my product, please give me an email, an information, and you will directly get this. It's an abonnement. And this is absolutely important. You have to check this every time. Understand criticism as an opportunity. Because as soon as the user is writing something about you, he's interested in something. He will tell you, hey, this was good, this was bad. Use this. Interact with the user. Show him that you're a cool product, that you're a cool site, that what this user is thinking about you is absolutely interesting for you. Because otherwise, this user will spend his money on other sites. Absolutely important. Look for a dialogue. Do this every time. About Ciao. Yeah, only 7 guys know Ciao. Right now, we are the price comparison site number 1. Ciao was born in 1999 as an opinion portal. So we started as an opinion portal. Everybody came to the site and wrote reviews regarding everything. Regarding a bottle of water, regarding a digital camera, regarding a car. Everything. And this shows that the users give us a trend because they want to show you what kind of experience they are making with several products. Chow was bought in 2005 by a company called Greenfield Online. I'm not sure if someone knows Greenfield. No. It's a market research company, a big one in US. We worked with them for 3 years. Last year in October, Microsoft bought us for $486 million, not euro. And so I'm really happy about this because they see what kind of potential. We are talking about Microsoft. It's really a huge company. And we are Chow, 200 people. Now a part of big mama Microsoft with about 100,000 employees. And this shows that they see what kind of trend there's really in the e-commerce or social commerce. Right now, if you go to the 7 countries, Chow is in UK, France, Germany, Spain, Italy, Netherlands, and Sweden. And every time you go to MSN and click on shopping, you will directly be forwarded to Chow. Means we are the shopping search engine for Microsoft or for MSN. The same with the new cool search engine, Bing, Bing, where we also are, the sub-channel. We are the shopping channel for Bing. Means everybody, someone is going to Bing and trying to find something. And he clicks on shopping, he will be directly forwarded to Chow. And this shows you what kind of potential consumer portals or user-generated content will have also for you. Trust, conversion. Right now, all over Europe, we have over 2.8 million registered members. Means members that are writing, doing something, not buying. They're writing and reading. If they buy, great, they should. We have over 5.4 million reviews. That is amazing. By the way, currently over 7.4 million products and services online, also interesting, and over 42 million unique visitors. This is per month. Means a lot of users are coming to our site to inform themselves, to have the cycle of purchase. If they want to buy something, first of all, they need to do the research and then show, or would like to know, okay, which product, which shop, which experience. And this is important. Yeah, I'm Marco Dinoy, and thank you. I hope you have questions. If you have questions, please tell me your name and from which company you're coming. It's interesting for me to know.
Hello, I'm Victor Minchu from Web Engines.
Hi.
And you had a very interesting slide just in the beginning.
Yeah.
About the online purchasing life cycle. Could you please bring it back?
Yeah, sure. Which one wasn't?
Yeah, it was some roundabout.
Come back.
Yeah. So this was actually very interesting. And you did give later in the presentation very good examples about what might be a break in this cycle, especially regarding user reviews.
Yeah.
But have you had any observation about each transition in this state machine, you might call it, about what might make the user break from the online shopping life cycle?
Thing is, good question, thank you for this. Thing is that your usability on the site must be really good. So you have to invest money. Every time see, okay, I will have now a new online shop, there are some buttons, great, blah, blah, blah. The thing is, you have to really identify the user, why he's going somewhere else. And this is something like experiences and also spending money on other customers, for example, on other companies that will show you why the user are leaving or when the user are leaving. Means if the button is yellow or black, or red, this make a huge difference. In Germany, a lot of companies are spending a lot of money regarding this, usability. The thing is, this circle is absolutely important. You need every time this information. This is a screenshot of the standard user that is coming to Chow. Means on Chow, he has the research. He's trying to find something in a search engine, let's say Bing or Google. He will be directly forwarded to Chow. Here, he can get all the information that he would like to have regarding this product. And this are real human information, not paid by a big, huge company. And there we see on our side that the circle is not interrupting. Means if a user is coming to read a review, there must be a cross-selling functionality that shows automatically what kind of products can be used or can be showed and what kind of merchant.
However, the main things that you're stressing about are essentially those that you might call is the transition between research and product selection, merchant selection, which is really the impact where user reviews make the big difference. But for instance, let's say I don't have money. Maybe I'll just stop until research. Let's say I have selected merchant or whatever. What might be the breakage between merchant selection and purchase experience?
Or negative reviews.
Okay.
Means if a shop, for example, have about 100 reviews and only 2 stars, so something like, hey, what is wrong with the shop? And why is a shop with 100 reviews something like cost of time to get those reviews? Why is he not changing something? Why is he not interacting with the shop? So it means reviews are more and more important. And this is something like where the user can say, hey, I will go to another shop.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Cool.
Evox, to the end of my clicks. I want to ask you, how do you prevent manipulative reviews? Cool. On a specific product?
That's really good. The thing is that we have a community. Means we have a really, let's say, sheriff community. As soon as they see a review, maybe written by a customer that says, hey, my shop is the best one, come and visit me, users directly will come to us and telling us, hey, this review maybe is not really true. We have several filter mechanisms. We have a community department which check every time reviews as soon as also users are coming to us and telling us something. The thing or the idea behind Chow is, what I did not mention right now, is that if you go to our site, log in and write a review, you will earn money with this. Means other users will tell you, hey, this review is really helpful. If your review is really helpful, means long story with a lot of input, then you will get more money by Chow. If this review is not helpful by the community, you will get less money. And this is something like how it works, how to generate really this content or user-generated content. It means also with discounts like Druckerzubehör, the printer site. And this is something like works. We have a strong community that every time sees us. And we have over 3,000 merchants right now across Europe, and they're happy with this. Good. Thank you.
My name is Konstantin from Favit. How do you make money, actually?
Ah, good point. Yeah, I will be paid every month. That's a good point. The thing is that, as I told you, we have over 7.4 million products online. These are products owned by Chow. Means we have products with all product information and reviews. All over Europe, we have about 50 million offers. Means we have a really huge portfolio. The thing is, every shop that wants to be listed on Chow has an opportunity to do e-commerce or advertising. Advertising means display advertising. And the standard model for advertising is CPM, means cost per mil. CPC is the e-commerce part. Means every time we will forward a user to a shop, the user or the shop has to pay us. Now it's important because the shop are spending money. But they're doing this because they have a great conversion. And why? Because they see Chow as a consumer portal that is really helpful before they buy something. Means the shop has a great conversion. Thank you for this question. You're good. Some other? Hi.
How do you feel about paid reviews? Do you think that shops might manipulate with paying users to write reviews, and do you have any experience?
Yeah, regarding paying, it's difficult because if you go to a user, you have your own shop and say, hey, if you write now a review, I will give you €5. Normally, this is not the right way. So the way like Druckerzubehör, this printer shop, did this, something like not similar, but give you a discount. Means he does this in a good way. He's telling the user, if you buy something, you will get an email, and if you write a review, you will get a discount. And this is the right way to do this. Thank you.
Hi, Natasha Mullins from BG Menu.
Hi.
In addition to the strategies that you told us about for encouraging people to generate content, yeah. Do you have any suggestions for from the beginning how you kind of generate a critical mass of reviews before you sort of go live to avoid the 000 reviews examples that you showed us?
Yeah, sure. The thing is, you have to offer the user something. Means if you're starting right now, let's say tomorrow you will have your own shop. First of all, everybody has to know, hey, there's a lady that has an online shop and have really nice site, really good products, really good service, but nobody knows right now. Therefore, the first step is really go to big sites like, for example, Chow, without doing any or too much advertising. But the thing is, use these consumer portals, because in consumer portals, the users are looking every time for information. And they see every time also online shops. And this is absolutely more value for you, because as soon as the user see you with your logo, it's something like brand awareness. Then, after a while, automatically, there are coming more and more reviews. There are so many ideas or so many placements that we, as Chow, can use in addition for users that says, for merchants that says, I want to push my review. I want to become famous. I want to become more and more or bigger and bigger. And we did this really with a lot of customers in a good way, where the user was really satisfied and also the merchant was really satisfied. So consumer portals are the first step if you're growing your business. Absolutely important. Cool. Hi.
Hi. Alexander Georgiev from Advertise. Just want to ask, you said you had two models for selling to your clients.
Yeah.
First one was CPM, the other one CPC.
Yeah.
What is the trend in regards to CPM to CPC? Which one is preferred more by the users?
Good question. Thank you for this. It depends on the market. Here we have really a huge difference between several markets. E-commerce is becoming more and more famous. Means social commerce is the thing what you have to use. The thing is, if you go now to big companies like BMW, yeah, or Ferrari not, but Fiat, something like this, and you tell them, hey, we are a huge portal, we have a lot of reviews regarding your product portfolio, regarding Fiat, regarding Mercedes, BMW. The thing is, hey, that's cool, because I have a new car, I have to do advertising. Because how should I, in the e-commerce part, promote BMW? There are several text links where you can say, okay, BMW have a new model, that's good. But the thing is, you need brand awareness. So both is increasing e-commerce more than advertising. Thank you. Additional questions? Did it? Ah, cool.
Colin Fusu and Neogen. Seems like the perfect business. And my question is, where the future threats might come from which areas?
What,
I don't know if you can.
What do you mean areas?
I mean, what kind of new competitors might appear? What do you think the future might bring? Because there's no like, the web is developing yet, and what new approaches might be interesting in this area, different that we have now?
So area means Bulgaria or means e-commerce? Okay, so for Bulgaria, the first thing, really, again, thank you to Plamen that invited me here to be in Sofia, first time. I saw only two streets in Sofia, so I cannot tell you if the city is really nice or bad. Sorry for this, but tomorrow I can. The good thing is, I saw right now this conference, and I was on several conferences, and this conference was really well organized. This shows me how big the interest is, for example, by Plamen or also the country to show, hey, Bulgaria, small, but we would like to do something. And now it depends on everybody of you that wants to do his own business. See this as a chance to see what kind of potential is there. And the potential is really trust and user-generated content. If you use this user-generated content and this trust, you will be successful. And the thing is, more and more users are getting online, are getting internet, and this for us is ultimately a potential. We have an eye on every country normally, where we see, okay, how many people are living there, how many people use the internet, how many shops are there. And the thing is you as retailer, if you say, I want to do my own business, I want to increase also the country, something like this, yeah, where you say, I want to have an online shop. This automatically is interesting for big companies, because then the big companies will come and see there's a potential in this country. Future e-commerce, social commerce, is really show the user what you really can do. Also regarding this product that you can touch in the offline sales, there are so many cool companies across the world that are showing, hey, this washing machine, for example, you can touch it in the offline sales, but in the online sales, we have so many cool videos, stuff where you can click, then the washing machine is open, and all the stuff. And this is something like, it's becoming more and more, let's say sexy, sorry for this, famous. And this is something like, that is the future. Means go to the user, have an interaction between you and the user. Don't see users as, yeah, he's spending money, nice, next one. See this user as a long-term user, because then you will be successful and the user will come every time back to you. Someone else? Not really? Okay, then, thank you a lot for the patience. I think, yeah, we're over the time. So, thank you.